Random, a treacherous frontier. These are the voyages of the channel Downsize It. Its continuing mission, to explore strange new genres, to seek out new games and new player communities, to boldly go where no nerd has gone before.
Greetings, my name is Ben, aka Downsize It, and I am here with Admiral Bodie at Gear Gaming Bentonville for a fun Armada battle report, an off-standard one. So I'm going to be running a subscriber-submitted list, submitted by Eric Dimmick, and just a quick plug to remind folks, you can still submit lists to the channel, although it'll get to them as often as I would like. You submit a list, and I put it on my spreadsheet, and I'll get to it when I can. I will put a caveat, though, that we might want to wait until this rumored AMG update comes out, because that'll probably make a whole bunch of lists obsolete. But anyway, just keep that in mind, that you can submit a list, and I'll try to get it on the table as soon as possible. So I'll be running a list by Eric Dimmick, and Bodie's going to be running a very off-standard list as well. We'll get to that in the post-game interview, but yeah, you guys will see what we mean. And also, I have an update on the giveaway. We'll be doing a $100 store credit to Admiral Tater, downsized dice, as well as a selection of your color of Admiral Tater ship dials with the nice notches on them, or shield dials, I should say, shield dials with the notches on them, and you'll be able to have your choice of color. So I'll be announcing the winner to that on around January 1st. So don't forget to subscribe and comment on my video starting November 1st through January 1st. Okay, so coming up next, I'll go over the fleets and the mission. Then you'll see Bodie and I deploying in a sped up fashion as we discuss our strategy and tactics in the pregame interview.
For the fleet submitted by Eric Dimmick, we have General Cracken on an assault frigate Mark II Bravo with the Paragon title, Flight Commander, boosted comms and linked turbolaser towers, 2 CR-90A corvettes with slave turrets, a Nebulon B support refit with salvation and spinal armament, and for squadrons, Hornhorn, Harrison Dula, Shara Bay, 2 X-Wing squadrons, and 2 A-Wing squadrons. For Bodhi's fleet, we have Admiral Constantine on an interdictor suppression refit with the interdictor title, Captain Nita, projection experts, disposable capacitors, G8 experimental projector, grav shift reroute, and SW7 ion batteries, an ISD Simoon refit with Governor Price, intensify firepower, Gunnery Chief Arnillion, Phylon Q7 tractor beams, XI7 turbolasers, and XX9 turbolasers, and 2 Gazanti cruisers, both with Comsnet and Reserve Hangar Deck, and 1 with Darth Vader. For squadrons, Sienna Ree, Valen Rudor, and 2 TIE Fighter squadrons. For points, Bodhi came in with the higher bid, and he chose to be second player. Therefore, I had the choice from his missions, which were Rift Assault, Rift Ambush, and Infested Fields. And I chose to go with Rift Assault. We'll place obstacles as normal, except we'll exclude the station and add the gravity rift. And for this mission, when a ship is attacking a ship, if the defender is beyond distance one of an obstacle, the defender doesn't have an objective token, the attacker can spend a die with any icon to assign an objective token. In addition, when a ship with an objective token is defending, so that means if a ship or squadron is attacking it, the attacker can spend that token to change a die face to an accuracy or any icon with a hit, or for second player, any icon they want, and then gain a victory token. And the Gravity Rift also does damage to ships who get too close if they're only at speed 1 or slower. So coming up next, you'll see Bodhi and I deploying in a sped-up fashion as we discuss our strategy and tactics in the pre-game interview.
Okay, so now that you've seen the fleets in the mission, you'll see Bodhi and I deploying here, sped-up overlay. And I'll go ahead and start off the fleet submitted by Eric Dimmick. And this is obviously meant to be about speed. We have General Cracken, you want to be speed 3 or greater, so you can get the benefits of the obstruction. And kind of how his instructions to me on how to, you know, play the list as far as certain things that are meant to go together. So Hera and the X-Wings need to stick together. You'll notice they're deployed separately right now, but that was just for deployment sinks. But they'll merge up here close enough. But they'll be activating in the squad phase, that's the plan, as rogues. Same thing with Corrin, he's a rogue. So we'll have some squadron phase, primary squadron activations and movement. Then Shara and her two A-Wings stick with the Assault Frigate, and that's what its squad commands are for, to harass enemy squads with my A-Wing group. And then if no squads are left, they still have black dice, so they are still effective anti-ship squadrons. Slave turrets on CR-90s is a little interesting. I don't think I've ever seen that before, but the goal for me then is to essentially, I'm not going to worry about double arcing. I just try to get front arcs, get the three dice, and probably do con fires when it's time to get four dice thrown out. Same thing with Salvation with its spinal, con fire to get five dice out the front, and it's try to maintain that long range firepower. And just if the red dice are not fickle, I have no dice mitigation except on the assault frigates. So my three small ships, I'm just have to see how the dice roll. Hopefully the red dice like me today. I do have Paragon, so that means I do want to try to get double arcs with my assault frigate, and so that way I can get the benefit, basically a front arc shot to set up the Paragon effect, and then the second shot get the extra dice. So we'll see how it plays. Lots of I need to be at speed 3. We have a lot of speed mitigation, and I intentionally chose Rift Ambush just because I think I maybe played it once before and it's going to make things crazy. And also because it fits in the theme of Constantine and all the tractor beams, which I will let you discuss now what you have.
Sure. So Ben asked me last weekend if I'd be free today to get in a game. And he said that he was going to be playing Rebels, and I didn't want to play Rebels. And I've been playing a lot of Republic, and so I wanted a break from that. And I do have some ideas for some Separatists, but I think I'm going to save those a little bit longer. So I decided, we'll have a thematic Rebels versus Empire battle. But I wanted to play someone that I haven't played in a little while and that I wouldn't really consider for a tournament game. And so I landed on Constantine. I feel like there's a little bit of untapped potential. He's definitely awkward, and the fact that his ability only goes off in the status phase is a little bit weird. Mm-hmm. But I think there's some interesting things that you can do with Phylons. The original list that I had put together used the Interdictor, the Gravwell upgrade to make them deploy at speed 0, and then trying to force surprise attack to make them deploy at speed 0 on the station. But I think that is going to be better with an Onager, and Onagers want to be outside of distance 1-5, which doesn't really work with Constantine, so it was just kind of awkward. All that rambling is to say, I decided on a Simoon. I had a Kuat for a bit, but some people told me not to do that, because things are just going to run away, which I think these things would run away, so
yes.
I'm glad that I have at least a wider area of coverage.
We're going to be trading long-range shots at each other.
Yeah. And I've been experimenting with this kind of, like, low squadron count idea in some of my recent lists. I've been flying a lot of heavy squadrons for a really long time, and I think, you know, if at least like in theory, just having four squadrons and some reserve hangar decks should be able to let me put more points into killing stuff and then, you know, delay your squadrons for enough time to let my stuff escape.
And this is a good delay ball.
Yeah.
But Valen and Sienna is a good combo, and then just having some extra junk chaff to that can cycle out with the reserve hangar decks. I mean, it's...
And it's just because I haven't played, like, any of this stuff in a while, so... I haven't played an Interdictor. I think this is the ship that I haven't flown in the longest up until today, so... it'll be fun to get an Interdictor on the table. And,
yes.
Yeah. This is just a fun list for me. I'm not expecting to do anything crazy. I did my cool bit making a stupid wall of obstacles here.
You guys will see that near the end of the deployment. One of the reasons you guys might be wondering, Ben, why are you deploying like that? Well, one, I wanted to see where he was going to be with his big ship. But also, I had the threat of him using that rift as a projectile with his graph shift reroute. And... if you deploy within range of the rift, you deploy at speed zero, and I didn't want to do that. So I needed to make sure that I was outside of range of a distance 1-2, moving an additional 1-2 my deployment, and that was kind of scary. But now there's this interesting wall of... Anyway, and you kind of want to be near obstacles in this, otherwise you're giving your opponent potential objective points.
Yeah.
So we'll see how that plays out. Yeah. Because I have Rift Ambush maybe once, maybe.
This is my first time playing it, so if I miss anything, then...
Yeah, well, we'll try to do our best not to miss.
Yeah,
the rules are a little complicated, so we'll try to make sure we're not missing the timings and stuff. Yeah. So, anyway, Bodhi and I will now plan our dials, and then we'll be back at the start of round one. Okay, start of round one. Kind of go over my positioning here. So, we've got my Nebula Class Star Destroyer standing in for my Assault Frigate Bravo. Speed 3. My marked CR-90, also speed 3. Got my X-Wings, my A-Wings, Shara, and Corrin. Hera and the Ghost on this side. I deployed her last because I just wanted to see where his main ships were going to be, and that's where I need her to be. Then Salvation at speed 3, and my unmarked CR-90 speed 4. Then I believe Interdictor Simon speed 1, correct?
Yeah, both the big ships are speed 1, and then both the flotillas are speed 2.
Invader's one in the middle.
Yep.
Right.
And Constantine's on the Interdictor.
Yep, Constantine. Which, I mean, makes sense. Yeah. Being thematic here, I love it. And then we have Sienna in the back there, and Valen on the far right, and then the
two generics.
Yes, the two generics. All right. So I am first player, so first goes to me, and we'll go ahead and get started over here on my right flank. So we'll go with my marked CR-90, or unmarked CR-90, I should say, and that is a navigate, and I'm going to use it to slow down to speed 3. I'm going to swing on out.
Sounds good.
They were here. There we go. All right, who we got first?
I'll start with flotilla number 1 in the back.
Flotilla number 1.
It's going to pass a concentrate fire token over to the Simon. Then it's going speed 2. And...
Salvation with Spinals is a navigate, but he will be taking a token. And I'm pretty sure I'm just going to do... Actually, we'll do this one. We'll side shuffle and a bit of an angled in like so.
Awesome.
All right, who we got next?
I'll go with the Interdictor.
Interdictor.
He's got nav. Let's see. Yeah, I'm going to take that as a token.
All right, we'll go with my Nebula class. It is a navigate. I'm going to use it as a dial. think there's any way for me to avoid getting distance 1 to 2, but at least I'm at speed 3, so I'm not going to take a damage. So we're going to do full turn.
It's only if you're at speed 1 or lower that you take damage.
Correct. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm glad I'm at speed 3, so I'm going to be good. But I will be moving a little bit slower next turn, because now I'm temporarily slowed down since I'm in the range of it.
Okay. Go with Simon.
And Simon.
It's got nav. I'm going to take that as a dial.
Very good. All right, the last one for me is my marked CR90, which is a navigate, and we're going to use it to speed up to speed 4. This is going to be my flanker. I'm going to probably be not till towards the end of the game before I get them within engagement. I don't want to get too close to the rift, but as long as I keep my speed up, I should be fine. I'm just going to eyeball this if that's right.
Yeah, that's fine.
Extra click at the one. Like so. Turn my swung around like so. And then lastly, we have Vader.
Yep. He's got engineering. He's going to comps that to the assignment. And I'm just going to make...
All right, and that is it for the ship phase of round one. We'll be doing the squad phase off camera, and then we'll be back for the start of round two. Start of round two. Let's recap the squad moves. Shara and the A-Wings are sitting on the rift with no ill effects, somehow. And then Corrin and the X-Wings and Hera are coordinating to get back into formation. And then Imperial Squad shifting over for anti-squadron coverage of their ships.
I have a ship phase thing.
Oh, ship phase thing.
Just going to do intensify.
Oh, intensify, yes. Intensify firepower. And we might have some shots, especially with me being first player. You can delay the side moon to the end. So, well... We are going to go with my assault frigate first, and it is a navigate. And I think I'll be staying at speed 3, but moving speed 2 effectively because of the rift. Isn't necessarily a bad thing. It helps me with my maneuverability. I'll get an extra click at the 2. So I'm going to land on this X-Wing. I'll still mess up my formation a little bit, but that's alright. Not too terrible. Right, so you get to place that X-Wing in the back there.
He can just go in the back corner where he's at right now.
Back corner. Very good.
Alright, I'm going to go with my non-Vader flotilla.
Non-Vader.
He's going to comsnet nav token to the Simon.
Navigate.
Just follow the train.
Okay. What's the range of Phylons?
Distance 1 to 5.
Ugh, arrow distance 1 to 5.
Yep.
Ugh, gross. And they happen...
When I activate.
When you activate. Okay. Alright, we will go with my unmarked CR-90, which is a navigate. I will take a token. Help me protect me from that. We'll turn as hard as I'm able without a nav dial. So.
Very nice. It's going to have us just out of range right now.
Oh, just out. Okay. Yep. All right.
We'll go with Vader.
Vader.
It's going to comms net a concentrate fire token.
Mm-hmm. next. We'll do my marked CR90, which is a navigate, which I think I'm going to take a token. Yeah, I'll take a token. Temporarily reduced to speed 3 because of the gravity rift. This maneuver right here.
Nice.
I'll allow there to be first blood shots.
Oh, a single red die is really gonna put you back.
Well, that's all you have. Am I out of medium?
Yeah.
Oh, well, then you don't have a shot, because I'm obstructed.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Cracken! For the win. That's right. It's a triple blue and a red. Mm-hmm. Siphon out the side.
I'm going to go with the Interdictor.
Interdictor.
It's going to take an Engineering token.
Engineering.
And... he does not have any shots currently.
I'm assuming the G8 is also distance 1 to 5?
Yes.
Now, that's during my activation, right? Because it's a temporary reduction.
Mm-hmm.
And how does Constantine work again?
At the start of each status phase, I may choose any number of enemy ships at distance 1 to 5 of at least two friendly non-flotilla ships, one or more of which must be medium or larger sized class.
I forgot the legalese.
For each chosen ship, you may discard one nav token or increase or decrease its speed by 1 to a minimum speed 1.
Yeah. It's kind of like reading the Anakin one.
Mm-hmm.
Stay out of salvation?
Yes.
Oh, just barely. Urgh, I was hoping I'd get a shot. Well, I have to go with salvation, and I'm not getting a shot. Got a nav. Take it as a dial. I've already got a token. So we're going to try to swing ourselves. Do that, then I don't. Then you're out of my front arc, which is a problem. I'm just gonna have to deal with the Simon shooting at me. It's all right. Okay, I'll do that. Staying at 3, using the dial to no effect. Coming in like so.
Activate Simon. He's got nav, which I'll take as a dial. When I activate, which I guess technically would be before that, I'm going to file on the token off of the salvation.
Woo! Still at 3.
And then I have a shot.
You do have a shot.
I have an obstructed shot to your side.
Yes. Double obstruction, if that was a thing.
Yeah. So it's going to be 4 red.
The Gunnery Chief with a double, if you want to use it.
Well, all right.
That's
really pretty solid.
Good start. We got 3 hits, a crit, and an accuracy to start.
Let's do that.
Gunnery Chief?
Actually, I'm going to just price it to a double.
Price it to a double. Very nice.
And I'm going to block your evade.
Block the evade, yep. Well, only thing I can do is brace and take 3. Was that in my side?
Yeah.
Yep.
And this is XX9, so yeah, both will be face
that's
up.
That's not a good thing. All right, first one, damage controls when I overlap a ship. Additional face down.
Okay.
Compartment fire, I cannot ready my defense tokens.
Mm.
That brace is staying exhausted.
Cool. That's all for my shooting phase. I'm going to use my dial and increase to speed 3.
Okay.
And then we'll add an extra click at the 3.
All right, very good. We are definitely engaging quickly.
Okay.
So, squad phase.
Yep.
So start a squad phase. Here's going to make that X-Wing rogue. I'm just out of range of that X-Wing. Mm-hmm. And then... So, I need to move 2. We might have some engagement. I don't know.
Maybe.
So we will start with my X-Wing that is not rogue, because his movement will not have any useful effects at the moment. I'm going to jump over here. Like so. And then we're going to take the rogue X-Wing, because he's not going to have really any effects on this. He's too far away to be... He'll move over here, like so. Okay. Then 2 to you.
Korn, speed 4.
Speed 4 is Korn.
So we could have a shot. Here we could have a shot.
Sienna coming in. Try to block.
Try. Probably won't be able to. Valen.
Did you take... Oh, you priced us, sorry.
Yeah. Valen can come in.
Okay. I think I'm going to go ahead and engage and do some shooting. I think I'm going to do anti-squad shooting. So we'll start with Korin. He's going to come in. He's going to snipe.
Yep.
Try to snipe Valen. As long as I'm out of scene at range. Yep. All right. Korin gets 4 blues for a snipe. That'll be 3 damage.
Valen will scatter.
Scatter. Okay, and then Hera. I'm going to see if I can get an angle that's outside of Sienna range. She has all that movement to do. I think I can.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So we'll do something like that. Alright, and the ghost. It's 2 blues, 2 blacks. Yes. I will stop your brace.
Okay.
Take 2.
I'll burn out the scatter.
Hey, burn out the scatter. Alright, and then to your generic TIE Fighters.
And they can just...
Yeah, which I think that'll be the last of the shooting.
Do that.
All right, and then then Shara and her alien squads. Yep. Come on here. Put Shara right in the middle.
That makes sense.
Yep. Put this alien for here. And this A-wing right here. Probably didn't position Hera the best way, because I'm not going to be able to rogue. Well, I can rogue my
A-wings.
I can do A-wings.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for round two. And we'll be back at the start of round three. Okay, start of round three. This is where we're at. Status phase, he did a really mean thing. He Constantined these guys down. So they're both at speed two now. So that's a problem. But we will be starting with salvation.
And ship phase, I do have intensify.
Intensify firepower, yes. Intensify. I'm just going to assume you're doing that every round.
I will let you know if it doesn't happen.
The comms knitting and everything.
Yeah.
So, salvation is a concentrate fire.
It sure is.
And we are going to be shooting into the side of the interdictor out the front.
Okay.
Then probably do a side shot, because I don't think I'd be double art. Do a side shot to the side moon, I think.
Correct. I think the line goes... Yeah, it goes right through the middle.
And this interdictor has Nita.
It does.
You have an evade. All right. So, starting with four reds with spinal. I'll be confiring in a red. It was all just straight up. It's not a very good start. Yeah, it's all right, I guess. two crits and a hit, and those crits count as two damage each. So actually, I'm just going to put this here to represent what the true damage will be if it stands.
I'm just gonna brace and redirect.
Okay, so brace to three. This will be five damage.
Oh, yeah.
The crits count as two.
Yeah, let me actually... I will just brace and redirect.
Okay, sounds good.
So I'll take one there on the side, and then I'll take two in the rear.
Perfect. All right, and then into the Simoon. I guess it does have a contain. This will be a red and a blue, also straight up rolling. I will do side to rear, actually.
Okay.
For two damage.
Three damage.
It's only at the front, I think, for salvation.
Oh.
Yep, only in my front hull zone makes the crits double.
Then, in that case, I will redirect it over to the
starboard side. Okay. All right, now for our movement.
Let me think if I want to G8 you or not.
Oh, yes, G8. I'm currently speed 2.
You're speed 2 right now.
You can temporarily speed me up or slow me down, right?
Just slow you down.
Or just slow G8. Down.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm going to make you go speed 1 for this maneuver.
Speed 1. Okay. We're in so many tractor beams. Are there things affecting me? I don't think there's any way for me to avoid double arc from you. Could have done it with speed 2. Or if I just go straight. Actually, I think I'll be fine. Fine. Not that line. It's going to be worse, but I also want to turn a little bit. Plan for next round. Or maybe I just need to run away. Maybe this ship is done. We'll just go straight to avoid the double arc. Okay, that was kind of messed up. That's where it should be.
Okay.
My didn't realize my hump in the middle of the The board messed up my mover tool when I pressed down on it.
Yep, definitely out there. All right.
Although, I think that then let me be double-arced by the Simon, though.
Yes.
So it's like, damned if I do, damned if I don't.
Well, I'm going to go with back here.
Tom's net.
Yeah, so number one, it's got engineering. Actually, that's kind of a waste, but he'll take it as a token himself.
Very nice. Okay, next I'm going to go with my unmarked CR-90. Tis a concentrate fire.
Okay. When that ship activates, I can exhaust the interdictor title and ready G8.
Ah, yes you can. Yes you can. When does G8 go off again?
Before an enemy ship at distance 1 to 5 resolves the determined course step.
Okay, so I can... So I do my nav token first.
Yes.
And then you decide if you're going to send me down. Okay. All right, well, we are going to be taking a... I believe it's medium range shot into the back of your Simon, because that's unobstructed. It's at least long range, but it might be medium. Out of medium, okay. Let's just eyeball on it there. All right, starting with two reds, and then we'll be adding in two more reds.
Okay.
Okay, initial shot. Then slaved. And confire. Alright, for two.
Okay. Three.
I'm sorry, I can't count, apparently.
And this is to my rear.
Yep.
I will contain.
Just take one internal?
Yeah.
All right.
And the reason I'm doing this is because I'm probably going to end up doing the Simoon, and it's going to get shot by the assault frigate, and I really don't want to lose defense tokens on turn three.
That is fair. That is fair. I'll be using my nav token to speed up to speed 3.
Okay. And then...
So... I'm going to... How fast am I actually going?
I think I like you at... So you only have to the front. I will allow you to go speed 3.
I'm going to go speed 3, all right. Choosing not to affect my speed.
Or actually, hold on, this might be the... Let's just do it for fun, because it's the only thing I'm going to
get. That you're going to be able to do it.
Yes.
Doing it just because you spent the interdictor title, damn it, so...
I will use my exhausted cards.
You'll go ahead and then do this little maneuver like so.
I'll go with Vader.
It's going with Vader.
Pass the confire token over.
Fueling the intensify.
Yeah. I will take a fix-up damage.
Just barely.
Unless I ram.
Unless you rammed yourself. I think you were going to be clearing the ship.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just barely got the shield dial overlapped.
Yep. All right, and it is compartment fire. Not ready his defense tokens.
I don't think he cares about that. Not as bad as the actual damage itself.
Yeah.
All right. My marked CR-90 is a concentrate fire. Am I in range of any of your GR-75? Or is it Gazanti?
This one.
All right. So okay. I will be using it as a dial then.
Okay.
Into your comms net. Or they're both
comsnet and reserve hangar decks, but this is the non-Vader one.
Yes,
you have the shot.
The non-Vader one. All right, Sam and his buddy start with two and then add two into the side of that Gazanti. Hitting a crit so far. Slaved. Nothing. Come on, accuracy. Confire. Nope. Scatter it away, I'm assuming?
Well, I can't... Oh, wait, no, this one can ready his defense turn. Yes. So, yeah, he'll scatter.
Yeah. Scatter away. Show that. All right, now movement. Speed on the dial is 4, but effectively 3, because I'm still close to the rift. Which I think I'm fine with. Just going to do this little maneuver like so.
Okay. I'm going to activate the Simoon.
Simoon.
When I activate, I will file on the CR90 down to 2.
Boo. And down to 2.
He's got engineering. I would like to have him dial and token for 3 shields.
Very nice.
So we're going to put 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
And then...
Well, I'm pretty sure my Nebulon's going to be getting shot at by one of your arcs.
Yes.
Is that a fair assumption?
That is a fair assumption. I think that's going to be my first shot from my side to your side.
Yes. And not obstructed because you slowed me down.
Yep. Well, that is a start.
It's a great start. Considering a certain officer you have on your ship.
The annoying part is I wanted 1 accuracy so I could like block both braces. But it'll be okay. So
yeah, we got 3 hits and a blank so far.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull. Well, first I'm going to intensify this to a hit.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm gonna trade it with
Vermilion. Yep. Very good.
And then I'm going to price that to a crit. And I'm going to say 5 damage to the side.
Well, I have to brace. And first one face up, if it's structural...
2 face up, because XX9.
Actually, I think I'm dead. Yeah, I'm dead anyway.
You can have me re-roll, though.
Oh, that's right, I can.
Yeah.
You didn't... I just assumed you're going to do an accuracy, but... Yeah, let's re-roll that.
Okay. Okay, so... Okay.
That might save me, but I'm still doing 2 face-ups.
Yep.
Yeah, so it's actually there. All right, still bracing to 2, both face-up.
Yep.
Not a structural. Thruster control malfunction. And not a structural. I cannot attack obstructed chips.
Interesting. Okay.
Are you going to take me off the board?
I think I'd like to. So that's 2 blues and a red.
It's a rear shot now. Maybe I should have done that turn. Oh, well. And there I go.
Yeah, I would like to do some...
Gunner Chief swapping?
Yeah. Yep. We'll do that.
All right, Nebulon. You lived and you died. You had a sort of okay front shot. And the speed shenanigans affecting Kraken. Doing their thing.
Yeah, I'm going to stay at speed 3.
Okay.
And I'm going to come and trample over a bunch of squadrons.
Sounds good.
So we're going to overlap... This
corn. Probably not corn. Looks like just that X-wing.
Okay. Yeah, corn will be fine back here.
Yep. I'll just that X-wing like so.
Sounds good.
Right behind you. All right. Well, you still avoided a double arc, so no paragon.
Yep.
But at least I get my side shot.
Yes.
Which we are gonna go with. My Nebula class Star Destroyer. Squadron Command. Using it as the dial. And I will be doing that now. I will not use Flight Commander.
Okay.
All right, I think I want to clear some things out. If I can. Yep, so... let's move this over here for now. Actually, this is going to be good for the entire play we're doing here. Do some planning. Yes, so... we will start with this generic A-Wing.
Okay.
Going into this generic TIE Fighter.
Sounds good.
Three blues.
Oh, very nice.
We'll just take them out.
Okay. I'm going to use number one's reserve hangar deck.
Mm-hmm.
And this goes at distance one with this activation. It was this one, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, that one. We'll do this generic A-Wing onto that generic TIE Fighter. Hey, can you do this again? Can your partner do a... well, just two damage. I'll take it.
Yeah.
And then we're going to do Hera to that generic TIE Fighter.
Mm-hmm.
Should barely kill it. Wow.
I'm going to use the other reserve hangar.
Yep.
Deck.
But now, she's going to lock down by Valen, so she's going to use her grit to get in range so that she can rogue her X-Wing buddies.
Very nice.
The squad phase. Well, the one in the back doesn't really need it, but I can if I want to. And then we will do a side to front into the Simoon.
Okay.
Three reds and a blue. I'll take that start, LTT. All right, four damage and an accuracy. What do we want to lock down? I think I want you to just take the damage, so we'll stop your brace.
Sure.
Take four.
Yeah, unfortunately, I think I'm just gonna... do that.
Okay. Movement. Speed on the dial is 3, but I'm effectively 2 at the moment because of the rift. Just a little side shuffle here. Like so.
Okay.
All right, and then to your interdictor. Okay.
Yep. I'll just reveal an engineering. I will... I guess dial and token it. Just to fill my shields back up.
Sounds good.
Because I don't have range for projection experts, unfortunately. And then I'm going to do...
we're going to be doing a Constantine slash? Constantine slash?
Yes. so there's going to be an unobstructed side arc shot here, and then an obstructed side arc shot there.
All right. Which one do we want to do first?
Let's just do the obstructed one because it's lamer.
Turn 90 on the left of your screen there, folks. Okay.
We'll intensify, and I have SW7, so 3 damage.
SW7s, okay. So effectively 3 damage. All right, well, I will have you reroll the crit.
Okay.
Why did I do that? I know better than that. I run SW7s all the time, but at least, well, reroll the double for me, just I want to see if I would have actually made
the,
myself
the hit?
Worth. Yeah, or the hit.
Well, I guess
I'm glad I didn't do that then. Did we replace him where he...
oh, shoot.
Because I think you moved him for...
I picked up that one, and then, like, I switched them.
Shit. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to redirect.
I don't.
You were roughly.
Yeah.
Here.
It was something like that.
Because you had to. Yeah. I was saying, I didn't kill him.
No, he's definitely not dead.
It was something like that.
I guess we can track it based off of this.
Oh, yes, where you replaced your... That's right, that's right.
I did somewhere around... it's something like that.
Yeah, that's close enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oopsies. Okay, and then...
To the other one. Unobstructed.
We'll just intensify and say 4 damage.
Reroll the red.
Actually, hold on. You're... I will... I guess block the redirect.
Block the redirect, okay. We will, I guess, not reset that. So we will do an accuracy for 3 damage. No redirect. Still reroll the red.
Yep. Okay.
Whew. Okay, that one actually...
So 2 damage.
So 2 damage total?
Yeah.
All right, you don't have a crit. But, all right. Shields off the front. Sorry, folks, if I'm confusing you with my little tray here. I'm trying to keep track of these as best I can for y'all.
All right, so even though it overlaps, it's actually the same, like it ends up in the same place, so
yep.
I'm just going
to
do this.
Yep, that works. Just to, that way you don't have to, yeah.
Cool.
Yep. We don't have to move your Gozanti. Right, squad phase.
Yes.
I'll be making both my X-Wings here, Rogue.
Yep.
With Hera. And do you have any...
I have no start of squadron phase stuff, so you guys go... They get to do their thing.
Yes.
Although, Hera should be toggled, right?
Did I not toggle her? I did forget to toggle her, yep. Well, so we're going to do... You do have a TIE fighter that can come and mess up my plan, so I'm going to do the X-Wings first. Bombing in the back.
They're both activated.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to...
So it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Okay, that's right. They come back activated. So, yep. Bombing in the back of the Simoon.
This is where it starts to hurt.
That's the hope. It's all just going to be straight up. No dice fixing. First X-Wing. For a hit.
I'll just take a damage.
Okay. Next X-Wing. Out of Siena. So in the back.
Sweet.
For crit.
I'll redirect that.
Right there. And then Corin. I think Corin is actually going to snipe at Valen. See if I can't. Get him off the board, combined with Shara. You just have a brace left on him, right?
Yes. Just a brace, 3 hole.
Yeah, take the shot while I can. 4 blues. stop the brace, take 1.
Yep.
Although, I should have let you go.
Oh, that's true. My stuff is just going to stay in place, though, because I don't want to deal with counter.
Yep.
Actually, they're counter 2, right?
Yep.
Okay, then yeah.
We're going to be moving Corin. Should be going to go speed 4. Although, technically, I did this out of order, guys. My bad. But he's going to fly back over here in preparation for harassing this Simon. All right, so now that's where he moved.
Okay.
Now we've got... They're going to be shooting at my A-Wings, I'm assuming.
I'm not going to...
Oh, not going to shoot.
Yeah, my stuff's just going to stay in place. Shara will be the
last.
So
just Shara. Yep, Shara then into...
Sienna. It is obstructed.
It is. For 2. Stop the scatter, take 1.
Okay, she'll take 1. And she'll counter, because why not?
Yep.
Maybe I should take my shots, but, like, I really don't want to die. So,
scatter. Stop player, take 1. Alright, very good.
I can mark her down.
Thank you. All right, that is it.
No,
round
it's not.
Three.
We have a status phase, and
oh,
I'm going to...
I keep reading status phase. No!
I'm going to drop this by speed one, and I think that's the only thing I can see.
Okay, Assault Frigate is down to speed two.
Yeah, that's all.
Keep reading status phase stuff. Damn, Constantine. All right, so my Nebula class is down to speed two, and we'll be back at the start of round four. Okay, here we are, start of round four. And state of the board. And my only ship that's at Kraken speed is this guy back here. Everybody else has been dropped down by Constantine and tractor beams and all that fun stuff. We are going to start with my Nebula class Star Destroyer. We are going to be revealing a nav command. And you're going to be taking a shot at the Simoon and then a shot at the Interdictor.
Sounds good. Does Paragon trigger on the second shot or the second shot on the same target?
I think it has to be the same target.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you really have to double arc somebody. Or have, reactive gunnery is a way that I've seen it done where you can try to get around that to get a salvo in first. All right, well, we're going to go to the Simoon first.
Sounds good.
Side to side. Although, yes, I decide. Let's drop those shields.
Okay.
Three reds and a blue. And also make your redirects not worth anything. Wow. That is a fantastic roll. I am not going to LTT anything. I like that.
Okay. I'm going to brace and contain.
Yes.
So, actually, I don't even need to contain because I braced to three. And I have three shields.
Yep.
One, two, three. And then two reds to, I'm assuming, the front of the Interdictor?
Yes, two reds to the front.
Okay.
Wow.
I'm going to have you re-roll the double.
Yep. Oh, back to it. Oh, man, Nita not doing much. I guess he needs to be choked out here pretty soon, I think. by Vader.
I guess I'll just... I'll just eat the three.
Just take it on the front?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Movement. I'm going to use my dial to speed up to three.
Yep. And then... The rift will slow you to two, and I'll G8 you to one.
Yeah, because I think I'm still in rift range.
Yeah.
Yep. So basically going speed one. And G8 slowing you down.
Yeah, it's temporary. So
the temporary stuff.
No, no that stuff.
Well, not yet. Not until your Simoon goes. Then you're actually, I think I'm just going to go straight. Yeah. Definitely wind over this A-Wing. Okay. Potentially, which I think that'll be it. Yeah. So you can place this A-Wing and there's its little token.
Yeah.
Am I out of both your double arcs?
I think you are.
I think that worked out in my favor.
Yeah. I do think it might have been funny if you stayed at speed three to, like, force you to ram
or run over an asteroid or something. Yeah.
But, so he's engineering.
Engineering.
I'm just going to put two shields on the front.
All right, who are we shooting at?
I'll do the four dice to the front of the CR-90.
Okay, my... Shields are down on the front of that one, and no Kraken. Speed two. Couple accuracies.
We'll just intensify and...
Call those damage?
He has no hull on him, right?
No hull damage yet.
Okay. I'm going to block the redirect.
Block the redirect. Okay, so we'll have one accuracy in play. The other one will be damage. So 3 damage. And you have... Do you have extra 7s on that one?
Nope.
No, that's on the side man. Okay. I'm going to risk it. Reroll the red. Whew, man, I'm getting lucky on those. Then we'll redirect.
Okay. I blocked the redirect.
Oh, that's right. You blocked.
Yeah.
It's even right there for me to see.
So face up and a face,
face
down.
Face up, face down. Power failure, man. Engineering.
Oh, no. Whatever. Shall you
oh,
do?
Oh, no. What am I going to do?
And then I'm going to have a front to side of the assault frigate.
Yeah, I should have moved this over here, guys. That's right. Front to side. All right.
Yeah, I'll let you check out.
It's a pretty good start, I think.
Yeah. I'm going to let it be 4 damage.
Okay, going to be 4 damage. Okay. Let's go ahead. I'll just keep risking it. Reroll the red.
4 damage.
Okay, then we will... I'm just going to use them while I got them. Base and redirect.
Sounds good.
And that was into my side?
Yeah.
I want to go to the front. Man, this is getting awfully crowded in here.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to go with this CR-90.
Okay.
That one is a concentrate fire. Shooting into the back. The interdictor.
Good.
Started with 1 red, and then adding 2 more. All right, initial shot.
Okay.
Slaved.
Okay.
Ooh.
Okay.
Con fire, come on, be an accuracy. Stop that. No, okay. Well, 3 so far. Race to 2. Just keep that running. Okay, and then speed 2. So.
Okay. I'll go with the lead Gazanti here.
Gazanti, which is Vader.
Vader, yep. He's got nav, which I'll take as a dial. I think I just have a side. Yeah. So we'll throw a single blue at you.
Okay.
And intensify.
And I've got exhausted redirect, exhausted evade, and regular evade. I will have you reroll that, because you don't have SW7s. All right.
Every single time.
Do you want to go out the other side? The other one?
It's obstructed.
Oh, that's right. I'm speed 4. Holy cow. Cracken.
Doing something for
I haven't been able to do anything with Cracken. I just completely forgot.
That's right.
Very good. Okay, other CR-90. It is a concentrate fire. I think I have obstructed to your back, but unobstructed to your side, correct?
Of the interdictor?
Interdictor, yes.
You have unobstructed to the rear.
Unobstructed to the rear. Of course, you have shield. Only want you to redirect so I could get some... internal damage. We'll go to the back.
Okay.
All right. 2, then 2.
I'm out of your front arc.
Oh, you are.
Yeah.
So 1, then 2.
Yeah.
All right. I was just eyeballing it, and I should have known better. All right. So first one. Confire. Slaved.
Not too bad.
I will take it.
I'll cancel one of the crits.
Cancel a crit. Evade is gone.
And then I'll redirect it.
Let's take one internal.
Well, I have 2 shields there.
Oh, redirect it that way. Crit again, yes.
But actually, I think I am going to just... I'm going to redirect it to this other side.
Yep, and then contain.
And then contain, yep. Yeah.
That makes sense. I am blazing at speed 4.
Oh, yeah.
Trying as hard as I can. Hit myself, and then go there. So we'll ram each other.
Okay. He's got squadrons.
The Gazanti. This is where I ended up. Squadron command.
And I think all I can hit is the two TIE fighters. So let's get them back in the action. Say hi to these X-Wings. I will make a shot, because why not? I'll do that here in a second.
Yep. I want to see those off camera.
Okay.
Or off and dice cam, I mean. But
I'll have this TIE fighter, because he could not. Yeah.
Probably not attack.
Yeah, I don't think so. But I will engage all three A-Wings.
Yes. Very good.
And then the TIE fighter has 2 damage on the one that's right on my butt.
Okay. Very good.
All right. He has no shots because everything would be obstructed and therefore canceled.
Yes.
So I'm just going to...
Yep. Then the Simoon.
Yep. Where is he? When he activates, I will file on. I'll file on the assault frigate down to 2.
Okay, 2 on the dial.
He's got engineering. I'll take that as a dial. I'm gonna, I guess, throw a shield and a shield. So I'll have 1 shield everywhere.
Side to side?
Yep, side to side.
All right.
Well, that is a pretty solid start.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Vermilion in this critical.
Vermilion, okay.
2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, I did do my math right.
Yeah, and then so it's going to be 5 damage, and you can only redirect 1 because XI-7.
XI-7s. I'm going to throw this away. You don't have SW-7s, right?
Correct.
So reroll a double and 1 of the blues.
Okay. So 4 damage.
Okay.
And still critical.
Still crit in there. I'm just going to burn everything.
Okay.
Race to 2. Redirect 1 to the front.
Okay. And then as for shot number 2, I have a rear flak shot. Because I don't think my front can see your rear. Oh yeah, definitely not. Yeah, I guess I'll just throw 2 blacks at each of
my X-Wings?
Yeah.
All right. X-Wing on 3 health.
We'll say 2 damage.
Oh, wow, X-Wing on 5 health.
And 1 damage. Or sorry, 2 damage on both.
Very nice. 1 health, 3 health remaining, respectively. Okay.
And then
the movement.
Moving. I'm going to use my token and drop down to speed 2. I'll overlap Corrin.
That's good. Corrin will just stay right up front.
Hair is fine.
You got 1 on all sides, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. We are at squad phase now.
We are.
Okay. Well, I think I'll be making both X-Wings rogue.
Okay.
Will be Hera. Sienna doesn't have a grit, right?
That's correct.
Okay. He's going to come in here and attack that TIE fighter.
Sounds good.
All right, so we can get the 2 damage I need. Got it.
Barely. Oh, wow. Very close.
Yes. Hera has been barely getting what I need her to get.
Yeah, early is better than not.
Yes. Then we're going to have X-Wing on 1 health. Over here, throw thrown to the side of the Simoon.
Okay.
For a crit.
I'll just eat it on the shields there.
Eat it on the shield, yep. Okay, and then it'll be two to you.
Okay. I mean, the only thing worth doing is having Sina
attack Hera.
Okay. And then I'll just activate this guy in place.
Valen will do nothing. Doesn't want to get the captures.
Yep. So I've got four blues with no swarm.
Okay.
Versus your single brace.
Correct. Single brace.
So we'll block the brace and have you take two.
All right. Brace, take two. All right. And next we'll do this X-Wing.
Yep.
Over here. Throwing into the side.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Mr. X-Wing. Double would not go amiss. One for one.
Okay.
Just out to take damage.
We'll redirect it to the rear.
Right to the back. Okay. I'll just throw into your front.
Okay.
For one.
I'll take the one there.
Okay. And then he's going to move back just a little bit. Then, assuming your other TIE fighter's not going to do...
He's already activated.
That's right, he already activated. All right, so first, this A-Wing onto this TIE fighter on 2 health. One.
Okay.
Other generic A-Wing on that TIE fighter.
Yep.
That's on 1 health. Got him. Ah, shut down him first. And then Shara will attack Valen. Still has a brace.
Still has brace. You need,
I need three
damage.
Three damage.
Or that.
Stop your brace, take two. I was incredibly fortunate.
They did their job.
Yes. Oh, they definitely did. All right, and then, all right, status phase.
So I'm going to Constantine this guy down to one.
All right, Assault Frigate is now at a true one.
And I think that's the only thing that I can...
Constantine, yep. Yes. All right, that's it for round four, guys. We'll be back at the start of round three. Or five. We're going backwards in time. Start of round five coming up. Okay, start of round 5. Intensify has been discarded to activate. It's out of range of the comms netting. Alright, so I need my first activation, and I think what it's got to be is going to be my assault frigate. I don't like being in this little traffic jam right here. And I'm going to reveal a squadron command.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll do it first. And we'll start with my X-Wings.
Okay.
First X-Wing. One on 1 health. To the side of the Simoon.
Yep.
That way your redirects aren't doing any good.
Okay.
Ah, nothing. And I'm going to move here in a second.
Kay.
And then second X-Wing. Oh my god.
Oh no.
Shields were down. And now I get no damage. Guys, what are you doing?
They were like, well, the A-Wings did their job too efficiently. We've got to...
Yeah, we don't
slow down.
Yeah, we don't feel like doing our job at all now,
yeah.
Evidently. So, that one there, and the other one will be... Basically trying to stick with this Simoon as best they can for the last
definitely.
Round. There. And then my last one, I'm going to do... Hera, she has grit.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to move and throw into your side as well.
Awesome.
With a blue and a black.
No bomber?
No bomber. For two damage.
Two damage. I think I'll brace that. I'll take him to the hole.
Then I'll do my rear shot into your side.
Yep.
And LTT. Mm-hmm. For two damage.
Now I'll keep the brace.
Okay.
Five hole on the side, man.
Very good. And then we are going to do side to side into the interdictor.
Yep.
And LTT. Pretty good. Yep. And we'll stop your redirect.
Okay.
Take three.
I'll brace and take two.
Okay. All right, now for movement.
I'm going to G8 you to zero.
Oh, that's right. G8s can move me to... That's
oh, yeah.
Right. Can tempt me to zero. All right, well, I guess I'm not going anywhere. That nice double arc that the interdictor's got on me.
Yep. First one of the game.
And I have no defense tokens.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
Hello. This guy.
Mr. Vader.
Yep, Vader.
Mr. Vader.
He's got concentrate fire. I'm going to...
Might he be shooting at my wounded...
You're welcome to
as well. Oh, thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, so a blue and then a blue into the front of the CR90.
Okay. Good start. I will redirect to my port side.
I would have loved to have seen an accuracy there.
Yeah, that would have been real bad. Because then it will come down to a reroll.
Yeah.
And, I might as well just go with him before he dies.
Okay.
Straight fire.
When he activates, I'm going to interdictor and get back G8.
Very good. And then he is going to be taking a front to rear medium range shot into the interdictor.
Sounds good.
Starting with two reds and a blue. Pretty good start. Confire. Slate. Okay. Let me get that, and that's four damage total so far. Nowhere to redirect.
Nowhere to redirect. Do you want to block the brace, or do you want to block the...
Or do I want to give you a face up? Take four. How much? You've taken one damage, right?
Taken one hole, yeah.
Or I can just give you four face down. I think I want pure damage. Stop the brace.
Okay. Well, I will contain for sure.
Yep.
And we'll take four to hold. So we're at five now.
Round six is going to be...
A slugfest?
A slugfest. Yeah. It's going to be crazy.
I think the squadrons are going to do a lot, though.
I'm currently speed two. Are you going to G8 me?
That is the question. Yes, I'll G8 you to 1.
G8 me to 1. That's mean. So if I could just go straight, I think I'm going to ram myself. I think shields will overlap. And if I turn... I don't think that's going to fit. So I have to turn this way. Order not to ram. Yeah. I think this is precise enough where I might need to mark that. So, got that.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks. Perfect. We're just going to do a one-click turn. Not dead yet.
Yeah. I'm gonna go with the interdictor.
Interdictor.
He's got engineering. I'll take it as a dial. Where do I want
going
shields?
To projection over here?
No, I'm actually gonna
Do some shield movement.
I think the Interdictor is in more dire need.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So we're going to do... Hera has not gone this turn. Or wait, she has.
Okay. Hera and my two X-Wings have gone. They went off the squad command. And this is just turkey shoot.
So 5 damage.
All right. That'll be 2 shields. And then... First one face up, point defense failure. And then 2 more face down.
Yep.
Halfway there. If you shoot my assault frigate, it's guaranteed dead.
Yes.
Because you have SW7.
Right.
I'm just dead
if
you shoot at me.
So I'd like to be able to shoot down here and then make that shot.
But that's not a guarantee.
Right. It is not.
It's a strong chance you will.
If I get more than one accuracy.
Yeah.
Because like I have to price the red to it. I have to have 5 damage.
Yes. And you got price.
And so price makes the red a double.
Yep.
And so that means on the 3 blues...
You have to have all...
I have intensify, damage. Though.
And you have,
so I have to have two of them be hits. So I'm going to take the shot at the assault frigate.
Okay. You don't have to roll. Okay. I'm dead. It's guaranteed with the SW7s. Yep. Kraken goes down.
All right, and then I'm going to be moving speed 2.
There's a structural.
Uh-huh.
Found one.
And I'm going to make this maneuver overlapping Hera.
Okay. I'll take that. Maybe. I'm probably still too far away for... roguing, but...
Ooh, did I manage?
Did you get out of range?
Well, yeah, I think I did. Because it would be obstructed.
Boo. Okay.
But you have a shot at the...
I do.
Down here.
We will take that shot. It is a concentrate fire. Let's see if we can get an accuracy. And then slaved and confi- Ooh.
Ooh. Okay.
Well, go ahead and take a 2.
Take a face up damage. Yeah. And it is.
What's that?
Ruptured engine.
Ruptured engine.
Okay.
Movement. Still blazing at speed of 4.
Yeah, he's zooming.
Probably should be navving, but nah, I need a con fire.
Yep.
Only getting 1 shot. This one, I should be able to just eyeball and be fine. Yeah, I'll just eyeball this one.
Okay.
Zooming around. Alright, see if this Kazanti can kill me.
So he's got concentrate fire.
Yep. You got me double arc too, don't you?
Sort of. I have a front to your side, and then I have my side to your front.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to start with that side to your front.
Side to the front that has no shields.
And, yep.
And it is important to know my starboard does have shields.
Yes. So I'm going to go ahead and con
fire on this one.
2 damage.
Reroll the crit.
Oh, that was...
Yeah. Burn the redirect.
Okay. And then...
Whiff. Ah!
Killer Gazanti's at it again.
Dang.
All right. He will be executing a maneuver at a speed greater than 1, so he will...
Take a damage on a shield?
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, man. Am I going to be able to kill a ship?
And then I think the Simoon... Yeah, the Simoon hasn't gone yet.
Yep, they'll be able to do some flacking.
Well, I also can throw a red die at you now.
I'm a... Kraken's dead, that's right.
Yep,
Kraken. Throw a red at me.
So... Simon has an engineering... Oh, it's not really going to matter because you're just going to...
Yeah, I have a double evade.
Yeah. I can file on you down. So.
Oh, you can.
Do you have a token on you?
I do.
Okay, so the token disappears.
Although my speed doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah. I will... Move a shield to the front, I guess. And ditch a damage card. So I'll flak. The only guy I can hit is the guy at one health.
Yep. Can you whip on your blacks? No, you kill him.
And then he still has all his defense tokens, so I'm not going to bother with that shot.
Yes.
I'm going speed 2. And Korn is speed
4.
Oh, 4, okay.
Good old E-Wings.
I'll go say hi to the Rift.
Alrighty. Squad phase. First, let's see if Hera's in range. She is.
Yes.
So Char and this A-Wing will be rogue.
Okay.
And we will start with them.
Sounds good.
Alright, what is the damage count on the Interdictor?
He has 5-hull.
And what is the damage count on the Simoon?
4-hull.
You've taken 4 damage.
Yeah.
What are you saying? Okay.
I had 5, but then I repaired.
Yeah,
one.
So I need to do 7 damage to kill him.
And 4
to... 4 to kill the Interdictor.
The Interdictor has more shields.
Correct. The Interdictor can rep better, but I also have a shot on the Interdictor for the final round. Man. So 7 damage, 8 because you have redirect.
That's yes.
What I need to do there. For here, it's... You've taken 5.
Yeah.
So I need to do 4... plus all the shields, but I will get a shot next. I think the Interdictor is my best play.
Okay.
To try to kill. All right. That's annoying, because I've been working on the Simoon, but I probably shouldn't have burned through. Well, I wasn't expecting me to go to 0 with my Assault Frigate. I was expecting to get out of your double arc. I can go wherever I want them to go, so we will... Go into your front to get away from your redirecting to 2 shields in the back.
Okay.
Start with this A-Wing. We'll just throw it here, guys. 1 black.
Oh, no.
It's not going to matter if my ladies can't hit. Shara. Corrin!
They don't approve of your decision to...
They don't, apparently. Wow, Arga just whiff all over the place. CNA can shoot at my A-Wing.
I'm not gonna bother.
Okay. I will shoot at you. Oh.
Yeah, for sure. It is obstructed.
It is. You can scatter now.
I will scatter, and then I'll counter back. Yeah. For nothing.
Oh my gosh, alright guys. Can you Constantine me?
I cannot Constantine you, because, unless this is somehow arranged. No.
Okay.
So you'll stay at speed 4.
One more round, guys. One more round. I've even been considering the objective
token. You okay if we put an objective token on him?
Sure.
Cool.
We're just saying that he could have taken the shot, and he could have spent whatever he shot to give me an objective token. This happens before my defense token spend.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Last round. I don't know if I'm going to kill a ship. All right. Concentrate fire. Into the back. Although I might change my mind on the location. If I can get an accuracy. Although I don't think I can see your side.
I don't think you can see it No. I don't think you'd be medium range if you could.
Yeah. So. I am medium range here.
Yeah, definitely to the back.
Yep, definitely in the back. We're going to be shooting. All right. Two reds and a blue to start, and then adding two reds. All right.
Okay.
It's a good start. I would like an accuracy. Slave. Okay. I would like another double. I'm just going to keep wishing for it. And a double. No. Okay. I'll still take that.
All right.
You have... The problem is that you're going to be engineering.
Correct.
Of course you're going to have an engineering.
Yes. I will have an engineering.
It doesn't... So it doesn't matter. I lost all my firepower. And my squad's whiffing. Stop the brace.
Okay. I will redirect. And do...
And all on the shields.
Yep.
Ugh. Alright, ramming speed.
I think I will let you stay at four? Yeah.
I'll you can slow me down.
Yeah, I'm not going to GH you. You can move however you...
Yes, we're going to do that.
Okay.
And I'll then do what my speed through maneuver would be. Should be this.
We will ram.
Yes. Two health left for me. Can you get the table?
Without that in medium range, probably not. I mean, I've got this one interdictor shot, which...
It's a pretty good shot.
I don't even know if I can see your side, though.
You actually just spend it. And you gain, yeah, you can turn a die to any face you want because you're second player.
Yep.
And you'll gain a victory token.
Victory. Okay. So then, I'm gonna go with the Simon first, because he's got to move.
Yep.
So this is engineering. He will.
You gonna throw a red at me?
I will throw a red at you.
Okay.
But I'm gonna put, I guess, a shield and a shield.
Okay. For nothing. Oh, well, you still have price.
Let's price it.
Press your double, I'll cancel it.
Okay. I guess we'll just go with the interdictor because it's the other big thing.
Engineering, I'm guessing.
Engineering, yep. I will. And I'm going to take off a damage card.
Okay. Shooting.
Shooting. So we are up to the mercy of this red die.
Side to front?
To your front.
Side to side.
To the front.
Front. That's a lot of accuracies.
Yes.
Good thing you have SW7s.
Yes. You have two shields, so I'll block the redirect with the red accuracy.
Then count these as damage?
Yeah.
Alright. Reroll the crit, so we can just get the crit off of there. But you stopped the redirect, so it doesn't matter. That kills me. things did not go according to plan. Or do you want to spin this and gain a...
No,
or do you want to actually kill something?
I could spend one... Well, no, it doesn't matter. I'd rather get the...
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, no, you spend it to change a die.
I'd spend it to change a die, but I'd still have to... Oh, wait, no, I don't spend a die to... Yeah, so
yeah,
we'll...
So you still might
we'll
as well
get it,
because
why not?
Do the... Yeah. All right, let's go do your move and see if my squadrons can salvage this disaster that happened. It's complete train wreck.
And then the flotillas are just going to shoot off into the distance.
Yep.
They have nav commands, so.
Yep. All right, squad phase. This is it, guys. That's what we got to do. Shara will be rogue.
Okay.
Oh man, that one doesn't have a range. So just going to be in this X-Wing. It's out of position. Alright. Well, all that's going to matter is Hera, Shara, and Corrin.
Is this Y-Wing out too?
He is out.
Okay.
And I wasn't in range to make it rogue.
Yep.
I don't think I got the firepower. Okay, we'll start with Shara.
I don't have an obstructed shot at Sienna.
I can't kill you.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to take the shot.
Okay.
Hit.
Okay, take it on the shield.
Hera. One hit, no redirect.
Okay, I'll take it to hull.
And yeah, it's not enough.
Yeah.
They whiffed last turn. Such a whiff and a crit.
Container and redirect. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my god. Terrible. We'll discuss it. Okay. Post-game interview. Oh my god. How awful was that? But we'll be back. The post-game interview. Okay. That was a disaster. That was really bad. 410 to something.
Yeah.
60 something.
16 plus 13, so that's 29.
29.
Yeah.
29. Yeah. That was awful. I think the MVP was Phylon Tractor Beams. But all the speed stuff, because he was able to keep me in his kill box between Phylon's Constantine. He was able to drop me from speed 3 down to speed 1 true speed, and then when I was in between both his ships, he was able to G8 me to 0 temporarily, so I couldn't move. So I was just in that double arc with SW7s, and I had burned my defense tokens.
I think if you had kept the defense tokens, it probably would have been different. I think the interdictor would have died, and I think if you hadn't died, like, you might have been able to escape. Because you still had quite a few shields to go through.
I did. Yeah. And it would have... And I would have been able to... Just being able to take another shot at the interdictor.
Yeah.
I think I would have gotten the interdictor. But man, the fact that, you know, you were just engineering the whole way. I just couldn't break through. And my bomber dice were so fickle.
Mm-hmm.
I will say, Eric, I don't like not having dice mitigation. LTTs on the assault frigate is like, oh, I mean, it's all right. But, oh my gosh, my CR-90 is only getting one shot. Not having LTTs, you feel it.
Yeah.
You feel it. Salvations, I mean, I'm fine with a spinal on salvation. I mean, that's, you know, you can, I'm fine with that one. But not having TRCs,
mm-hmm.
That's what I meant to say, TRCs on my CR-90s.
Yeah, it feels like such a staple.
Yeah. And not being able to, it's just, you feel it not being able to shoot twice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you had a lot of double arcs that even just chip damage on the flotillas.
Could have made a difference. Yeah. Yeah. And not having the bomber dice fixing, even though I technically only have 3 bombers, red dice bombers, it's like, ugh. But
yeah.
And you were able to just make Kraken ineffective, dropping me with all the speeds. Oh my goodness.
When we looked at each other's list at the beginning, we both kind of found it interesting because Ben was worried about like me being able to stop him from doing Kraken stuff, which ended up being the case. I was a little bit worried because all of his things want to be going faster anyway, that, you know, I would never get the opportunity to actually drop it down. I guess I kind of like underestimated how much like overall speed control there is.
The overlap that you had.
Constantine can do any number of ships, which I actually didn't even realize until I read it to you in like turn round one or something, which let me slow down both Salvation and the CR-90.
And now what I could have done is spent more, maybe I should have done just more nav dials to affect that, but...
Yeah, if you nav a lot, because nav tokens I'm able to interact with a lot, but nav dials, I really can't do anything. Like, every time you flipped over a dial, I was like, please don't be nav.
Yeah. And maybe I should have done that, but I was thinking I just need to get firepower in.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe I should have been navving. Might have made a difference.
I know.
Yeah. But on the assault frigate, it's like, do I nav? Do I squad command? Do I
engineer? It's weird because, yeah, it wants to do kind of all four commands.
Yeah.
And so, like, I found myself, like, I can't fly assault frigates as carriers. Like, they just need to be navving and engineering.
Yeah. Or if it's going to be a carrier, build around it to be a true squad list. You have your bomber commands. You have other ships that can do other things.
Like Torn Far, Hera. All the overlapping rerolls.
To really make them effective. But yeah, this assault frigate build with this fleet, you really want every command.
Mm-hmm.
Especially against your fleet.
Yeah.
Like, against Constantine, I don't think I'd care about navs. I'd just set it at 3 and just fly at 3 around the board. But with you, it's like, well, now I need navs, but I also want to command my squads.
The issue
but I also is... want need to heal myself.
I know. Every time I send an assault frigate to speed 3 without a dial ready, I end up going off the board.
Really?
I don't know why. That's just...
But yeah, it was. I liked playing a non. It was interesting playing a list with the non-standard takes on stuff. But
yeah, I specifically chose things that, like, having LTT on the Simoon. There was one attack where it's like, man, I wish I had LTT.
LTT
it's actually against the flak shot. I would have been able to take out one of the X-wings one turn earlier. But you know, the XX9s did a
they
little
did work.
I mean, it was all just kind of damage numbers more than the face up, but it was fun to do.
Yeah. And just so you guys know, we didn't know what our fleets were coming into it.
Yeah.
It might seem like that. It was like, man, that's a hard counter to Kraken that Bodie brought.
But all we knew was the faction.
Yeah. All we knew was the faction. So, but that was... anyway, keep sending lists in, guys, because it's fun to try out new things.
Yeah, I'll fly something next time.
Yeah.
I'm down to fly any kind.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks. Send those subscriber submitted lists in. We'll try to get them in. And if you send them in before the rumored AMG rules drop comes in, we'll play it with the pre-rules.
Mm.
That way it's not just complete wasted, or we'll try to get it in. Who knows when these rules are going to come out?
Yeah.
They're supposed to be out rumors
in October,
by now.
Yeah.
But who knows? We'll see. All right. Well, thanks for the game.
Yeah.
That was proper shellacking. But but thank you for the list submission, Eric. And don't forget about our sponsors, guys. Baron of Dice, Admiral Tater. Go to their store, support them, use the discount codes. And until next time, take it easy.